Hi, thank you for your interest in the Block webcam and microphone application developed by xSecuritas. In this video, we will see how webcam and microphone are protected from malicious programs. First, I will explain how to protect webcam and microphone from malwares and viruses. When some program attempts to access your webcam or microphone, it first checks whether the program is already allowed. For your convenience, we have predefined programs that are mostly used as allowed programs. If an allowed program attempts to use a webcam or microphone, it is accepted. If a program set to deny attempts to use a webcam or microphone, the program will automatically shut down and block the webcam. If the program is neither allowed program nor denied program, it will prompt the user to decide whether to allow or deny. When these windows are displayed, the user can choose whether to allow or deny the program. Now let's run the Block webcam and microphone program to see how the allow and block is exercised for an application. First, let's create a simple policy by clicking the Edit Policy menu. In practice, you do not actually need to create policies, and you can use the policy that was set by default when you installed the program. On the Edit Policy window, the first thing to do is to register the programs you want to allow. Just drag and drop the programs you want to allow into the right area. In the example, the program allowed.x is registered as an allowed program. Please be careful. Use of webcam or microphone in web browser and Windows default program is allowed. It is a window to register a program which is not allowed. But this is not often used. In the example, the program disallowed.x is registered as a disallowed program. This window shows the items that are allowed in advance. Of course, you can turn off the checkbox on left and exclude it from the allowed items. In the list, there's an item labeled Application for Company. Application means only allow the specified program. Company means allowing all programs developed by a particular company. Finally, choose whether to control the webcam and microphone. The default is to control. Another option is to display the alert window when blocking unauthorized programs. With this, an alert window is displayed in the tray area. When the policy is changed, its contents can be checked from the current policy menu. Now click on the Minimize to Tray button, send the program to tray and test it. The allowed.x program is allowed in the policy. Let's check this. You can see that the webcam works normally. Disallowed.x is a blocked program. Let's check this. The program is forcibly closed and the alert window is displayed. The policy works fine. In the main program, click the View Log menu to view the log. Now the two programs we tested are displayed. One is an allowed program and the ones marked in red are blocked programs. Now let's run a program that is not specified as an allow or block program. The program is forcibly terminated and a window asking whether to allow or block this program is displayed. If you click the Allow button on this window, this program is allowed from the next execution. If you click the Block button in this window, the program will be stopped from execution. Company field is blank. This is a program without a digital sign. I will explain this later. In this example, let's allow amcap.x. Let's run the amcap.x program again. Now you can see that the amcap.x program can use the webcam normally. Now let's examine how the policy has changed. As you can see on the window, you can see that the amcap.x program is registered in the allow program. You can also see the amcap.x program running in the log. On the desktop, there are sino1.x and sino2.x programs. These programs are not set to the allow or disallow in policy. Let's run the sino1.x program. Now that it's not an allowed or disallowed program, you'll see a window asking you to allow it. Look at the screen. The company field displays the value xSecuritas, Inc. This means that this program has a digital sign under the name xSecuritas, Inc. The digital sign value of the program can be checked in the property window. You can see that the digital sign of sign 01.x is xSecuritas, Inc. Similarly, the sign 02.x program's digital signature is xSecuritas, Inc. If you select for all products of this company in this window, it means that you will allow or disallow all programs created by xSecuritas. If you select for this program, this means that only currently selected program, sign 01.x, can be set to allow or disallow. In this example, select for all products of this company and then click the Allow button. As you would expect, sign 01.x is a program developed by xSecuritas, so can use webcam normally. Let's run the sign 02.x program. Sign 02.x is also a program developed by xSecuritas, so webcam can be used normally. If you check it on the Edit Policy window, you can see that the Allow program has type as company and name as xSecuritas, Inc. On the Edit Policy window, delete the xSecuritas entry and try another test. Run sign 01.x again. Since you've deleted the policy, you'll see a window asking for allow or disallow. This time, select for this program and click the Allow button. Sign 01.x now uses the webcam normally. Run sign 02.x again. Since you've deleted the policy, you'll see a window asking for allow or disallow. This time, select for this program and click the Block button. Let's run the sign 02.x program again. Because the sign 02.x program is not allowed in the policy, execution is terminated. In the policy editing window, sign 01.x is registered as an application in the allow item. You can see that the sign 02.x program is registered in the disallow entry. You can see Skype is already in allowed application list in predefined items. Uncheck the Skype program and exclude it from the allowed list. Now when you run the Skype program, you will see a window asking to allow and disallow. Last explanation. Exit the Block webcam and microphone program and run another program that uses webcam. All programs that use webcam will now be forcibly terminated or cannot use the webcam. How is it? A malicious program can steal your information by compromising with your webcam or microphone. We are sure that you will be able to block any unauthorized use if you use Block webcam and microphone application. Thanks you for watching.